Hello everyone, welcome back. It is Sunday. Yeah, something like that. Getting a little rain this morning, calling for some severe storms today. Things are really, it's like spring has really hit in the last week. Not getting a whole lot done. I've got to get some ground ready to plant the corn and set some broccoli and cabbage. We're about the middle of April, so last year I planted corn this week. I probably won't get it done this year, which is fine. That didn't work out as well as I hoped last year, but it went all right. Levi had his first cow show yesterday, showed one of his heifers. Didn't place in anything, but it was a good experience, and so we done that yesterday, and that was a lot of fun. I think we enjoyed it, and we did secure the pasture, the extra pasture. That lease is signed, everything's done there. We're moving right along. Yeah, starting to rain again. Winds are howling. But that's kind of where we're at. The other day I done a video on spraying between the strawberry beds. And they're looking really good. Strawberries are. Got to get them fed and all that good stuff. It's probably going to be a busy week for me. I'm going to try to fertilize some hay ground and get some things done on that side this week. But there's always something to do. But I done the video on the spraying the herbicides between the strawberries, and the thing about the use of ag chemicals is years ago I made my living as a mechanic, and in my toolbox I had a lot of different tools. Some of them I didn't use regularly, but when I needed them, they were very handy. They made the job a lot easier, more efficient, etc., etc. Some of the tools I had in there, you couldn't do certain jobs without them. They were, specialty tools that may lay in the toolbox drawer for months, but when that job came up, you had to have that tool, or you couldn't do the job. Ag chemicals are a lot that way, and I know the other morning I woke up, I went to sleep with the TV on. I have a bad habit of watching Gunsmoke at night. I like Gunsmoke, so a lot of times I'll flip the TV on, watch Marshall Dillon and Festus, and go to sleep with TV on. But anyhow, I went to sleep with TV on. I woke up and there was a commercial on talking about Roundup. Class action lawsuits, stuff like that. So a lot of times ag chemicals get bad reputation. And I'm not saying that it's completely undeserved. That's above me. But in the Roundup commercial, it said the World Health Organization had deemed Roundup as a possible human carcinogen, cancer-causing agent. I struggle with that word. But, so if you delve a little deeper, what the World Health Organization deemed was that they couldn't prove that it did or did not cause cancer. So, but... Back to the story here. In that toolbox, ag chemicals are the same. They're tools. And if there's been a lot of pressure over the past several years to have certain ag chemicals removed, either for environmental reasons or human health concerns, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Some of them are very well founded. I you know, like I said, once again, that's above my pay grade. But every time you remove a tool from that, what it makes farming a more difficult task. And let me support that statement by saying, I could go in those strawberries and hand weed them. I can go in there and cultivate them. I can go in there and do a lot of things. There's a cost to it. It probably costs me time, labor, and everything, $15 to get the weeds out of those strawberries. The problem is, and I run into this with corn, sweet corn, people will want it like a non-GMO corn. And for the most part, they're asking for the corn. Some customers want non-GMO corn, and they want corn that's not got the herbicide-resistant gene in it, and which is fine. We can grow that. My input costs are going to be higher. If the customer is willing to pay extra on the retail end or on the purchasing end to offset those input costs, that's fine with me. That's okay. If they're not willing to, I can't do it. I can't lose money by growing it. So you run into that quite a bit. I know that a lot of times the ag chemicals, the sprays, the herbicides, the pesticides, the insecticides. Actually, pesticides is insecticides and herbicides, but fungicides, whatever. You run into that a lot. And a lot of times it's because of a lack of knowledge of the chemical and the use. The biggest threat of ag chemicals is to the applicator. The people who actually apply them is the biggest threat. But, you know, that's just some thoughts, my opinions, my look at it. But, you know, as the chemicals are removed from the market, you know, there's some insects and some diseases that are hard to fight in certain crops without the access to that toolbox of ag chemicals, chemistry. So, and, you know, same with weeds. Yes, we used to hand, I have used a handheld hoe many, many days. I have held on to a 4-foot cultivator behind a horse many, many days. I've done it. I could do it again. I have to grow less, and, you know, I'm going to have to charge more. And at the end of the day, that's, or not do it at all. That's kind of the three options that we as farmers find ourselves in. Now, there's folks that grow organic and they do really good. That's not what I'm not bashing or picking on any method of growing. It's just, once again, you know, the point of these videos is I'm telling you my story and the approach we take to try to maintain our operation. So, growing vegetables is getting tougher and tougher, plain and simple. It's getting tougher and tougher. And there's a lot of reasons for that. Competition from other markets, foreign markets, competition from, people not low cost of food, and people, you say low cost of food, which, you know, in this country, food's relatively cheap. There's also people in this country starving to death because they can't afford food. So, you know, it's a big question, and I don't have the answers to it. But, you hear a lot about ag chemicals from a lot of folks that are not involved in ag. So, that makes a big difference. They are some chemicals I don't like to use. They are some chemicals that I won't use, just because of safety concerns for myself. And, you know, if If I'm concerned for the safety of myself, I'm definitely not going to put it on a product that for people to eat. So, you know, I don't have a problem with it. But there's also some very safe chemicals. I mean, not if used properly. And of course, you know, that's another thing. If you own a home, there's probably stuff under your kitchen cabinet or wherever you store your household chemicals a lot worse than, a lot more dangerous than the ag chemicals we use. So, you know, that's, it's interesting. But, you know, that's just one of the things in modern agriculture that we face. And, you know, we probably always will, and it's just part of it. And, you know, as farmers and growers, we have to be very, you know, we're always having to be very resourceful. If we're not battling the perception of the public, we're battling markets. If we're not battling markets, we're battling the weather. And that's just farming. And, you know, if you're farming, you know that, and if you're not willing to deal with that, you shouldn't be farming. And that's just part of it. Okay, I rambled on long enough. If you like what we do, please subscribe. If you have subscribed, thank you. Let me know what you think about that ramble, whatever the heck it was. And we'll catch you guys later. We're going to probably be putting out some fertilizer, building fence, getting ground ready, putting down plastic mulch all within the next couple of weeks. So until next time, take care of yourself.